The College Football Experience TCU Horned Frogs 2022 season preview episode on the Sports Gambling Podcast Networks presented by WinBet. Bet $100 at WinBet and get a $100 free bet. Head over to sportsgamblingpodcast.com/winbet. That's sportsgamblingpodcast.com/WYNNBET to claim your free bet today.
Hey, what's up, you degenerate gamblers? This is Bill Burr, and you're listening to SGPN. Let it ride, baby.
TCU Horned Frogs 2022 season preview episode. My name is Colby Swiggin, Dantabase Dan, aka Pick Dundee. That's not a pick. This is a pick.
He was raised in the land down under, where a man thinks on his feet, speaks with his fists, and lives by his wits.
When Dundee happened, he was a superstar.
I smoke and I drink and I don't have stress and I'm healthy.
Talking Horned Frog football. Gotta talk about, I mean, if you're watching on YouTube, subscribe to the College Football Experience on YouTube, but got a photo of a guy behind us up on the projector here. Shout out to the SGPN graphics team. And it's a bit odd to talk about a guy that's not there anymore, but a statue still there. We're going to get into it. I am joined by my co-host. Give it up for former JMU Duke defensive back, the burrito eating, sideline kiss stealing, wheeling and dealing, Patty C in the place to be.
Hi-oh. Well, got one. Something in the throat there. Got a horned frog in the throat there. I don't know. Gotta drink some Modelo,
buddy. Let's go. Because Gary Patterson's gone. He's gone.
Yeah, he's been there the entire millennium so far.
Since your mom was wiping your nose. All right.
Yeah.
Not really, but maybe.
You know, I'm a slow developer.
But he's gone. Damn, it's just like 6 or 7 years ago. They were almost in the, they should have played for the fucking in the playoffs. They got robbed.
They did get robbed. You know when they really got robbed is when they finished the season undefeated and beat the number three team in the country on the final game of the regular season and still finished only number two.
Oh, they won a national championship in my mind.
Yeah. That banner should be up.
They have national championships. All right. But in comes in Sonny Dykes, Patty C, brand new head coach. His dad, Spike Dykes, legendary or famous coach in Texas at Texas Tech back to the Bam Morris days.
Interesting play by Texas Tech not going after him.
I thought that was a, if you listen to our Texas Tech people, go listen to it. But I thought I was higher on the Joey McGuire hire than the Sonny Dykes hire.
Ooh.
Now you look at Sonny Dykes, Patty C, Mike Leach guy. Had success at Louisiana Tech, kind of struggled at Cal. Got SMU going though, and
he's had a couple good years with SMU.
Seems like he's been better in the group of five, but hey, I know it's hard to win in Berkeley. So 71-63 as a head coach, Patty C. What do you make of old Sonny Dykes?
Well, he's going from his right. I mean, he was what? He was an analyst at SMU in 2017, offensive analyst. And then over to TCU. He was in TCU in 2017.
Yeah.
Then went to SMU. So already a little bit of bad blood, I'm sure there. But then boom, back to TCU.
And you got to wonder with SMU starting this NIL collective, how could they could look? Maybe he's leaving. SMU for TCU is a foolish thing. Who knows?
Well, when we get to recruiting, I was surprised to see how well TCU has recruited. So maybe not.
Well, 10-3 in 19 was the big year, I think, for SMU, right? He did beat TCU twice too. So
if you can't beat him, we'll have him join
my
you.
My problem with the hire, man, is that SMU kind of never beat anyone besides TCU of note. Like, to me, they didn't really ever, like, they always lost. I mean, I guess they beat UCF last year, but I think UCF was on their like third string quarterback. But either way, it's a nice win to have, but you still lose to Tulsa. You lose to Memphis. Memphis was dog shit last year, I thought. I mean, they were 6-6, but I didn't think they were very good. You go back to 20, they were 7-3. Who do they? They lost to Cincy, lost to Tulsa, lost to ECU. This is what I mean. ECU wasn't even good that year.
Well, to the good folks at TCU, he did beat Texas while he was at Cal back in 2015.
That's true. That matters. That matters. I mean, even that special year, they lose to Navy and they lose to Memphis. I just don't know that I'm buying into the hire, buddy, but I don't think he's going to be bad. I just don't know if he's going to be good. And replacing Gary Patterson is tough, man.
Yeah.
Tough, but let's,
you don't replace Gary Patterson.
What do you make of the hire? If you had to grade the hire,
I don't think I'm as tough on it as you are. I think you're kind of pretty unimpressed by it.
Well, I just didn't think he was very good at Cal.
Yeah. I mean, what did he do at Cal? He was 5-7. No, 1-11, 5-7, 8-5, 5-7. He was trending in the right direction until that final season. Not sure exactly what happened there, but
even at SMU, I'll say like they never truly impressed me.
Wait, he beat Texas twice while he was at Cal.
That's amazing. That's probably why they hired him. Like, I've beaten Texas twice. Hired. Let's hop into it though, because
I'll give it like a C plus hire.
I do think he has a talented team, so maybe he can make me look like a moron. Maybe he can make me look like a moron. Let's talk about it, Patty C, because he is walking into a team last year that was the 65th best scoring offense in America, 29th best rush offense, 60th best pass offense, 36th in total offense. But get this. I promise you, they're not going to run the ball that much.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, we were looking at it before the episode. Efficient offense, 10th in the country in yards per play, but 100, I think, 10th in total plays run. I mean, let me rattle off a couple stats for you here. In terms of conference leaders, the number 2 and 3 leader in the conference returning, but they were number 2 and 3 in the conference in yards per catch, and number 1 and 2 in the conference in yards per rush. Now, obviously, what's the name? Evans is gone. We'll talk about that. But the offense was efficient under Patterson.
Yeah, they had Sonny Cumbie, who is a Mike Leach guy.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I guess the shoe fits for bringing in Dykes, and I see that
should
side
be an
of
easy
it.
Transition, you would think.
But at the same time, I also wonder if the reason why that wasn't working in the Big 12 is because if any conference has ever had, you know, they have seen Art Briles, Dana Holgorsen, Mike Leach at Texas Tech. I'm probably forgetting when Kansas had what's his name? Lincoln Riley is a Leach guy. So, I mean, they have had so many of these coaches, the Leach coaching tree, just go through the Big 12.
I guess what was someone always in the SEC his entire time there?
When I'm not sure. I'd have to go back and look.
They might have been there for like a year, but that's been ancient history.
But you see my point, though.
That conference,
Kingsbury,
you're right.
Cliff Kingsbury. I mean, you can go on and on and
they've
on.
They've seen almost nothing but spread.
So that's why it's not a, like, to me, I'm not really excited about it. But offensive coordinator is Garrett Riley. Maybe he makes me look like a fool. They got talent. Max Duggan, we're high on. Unfortunately, I don't really see how Max Duggan will fit into the air raid. I think he transfers in the next couple weeks. Chandler Morris will get the start, if I had to guess. Former Oklahoma quarterback. Zach Evans is gone at running back, but Kendre Miller's there. He played solid last year as well. Wideouts, Taye Barber and Quentin Johnson are back, and also freshman Jordan Hudson is one to keep an eye on. Tight end Jared Wiley is back. 3 of 5 on the offensive line are back. It's, in a way, it's kind of like 4 of 5 when I get to the transfer portal. They went out defensively and hired Joe Gillespie, who I think is a solid defensive coordinator. Comes over from Tulsa. Remember when Zaven Collins, they had that really good defense. they're going to need it because last year, even with GP and his hit singles, they were 118th in scoring defense, 122nd in rush defense, 86th in pass defense, charting at the number 119 defensively. That's unheard of in the Gary Patterson era.
I was looking back at like 2010 and I was just like going through a few years trying to find some other stats. And TCU was number one in the nation for at least 3 years in a row. Like, yeah, and maybe longer than that, but they were certainly never outside of like the top 10 for a long ass time.
Seemed like they quit on him last year.
It seemed like, in my opinion, but he had been slipping over the past few years.
Well, I think a lot more teams are running that defense. So offenses are getting more accustomed to facing it.
Yeah.
Maybe that's it. Eight starters are back on defense, Patty. C, 2 of 3 on the defensive line, led by Terrell Cooper. 3 of 4 in the linebacking core, led by D. Winters. 2 of 4 in the secondary. But in a way, it's kind of like 3 of 4 because they bring in a nice transfer, their kicker and punter back. Patty, see, when I look at the roster, I say, hey, you know what? Not a bad team.
Talent is still there.
Not a bad team. What do you make of the whole team?
Well, yeah, there's plenty of 4 stars all over the roster. In fact, more than I could probably even rattle off here without wasting everyone's time. But it looks like about 20 plus 4 stars somewhere on the roster here. To jump the gun here, they've been basically number 3 in the Big 12 recruiting behind Texas and Oklahoma. Now there's a gulf behind those two teams, but there should be plenty of talent. Obviously, again, Evans is a big, big loss.
Yeah, Zach Evans heading out to Ole Miss. We're going to get to the transfer portal and the transfer portal, they were very active. We're going to get to that. We're going to get to recruiting rankings and how basically we see how Las Vegas sees TCU doing in 2022 and how we see TCU doing.
I got one question before we jump into these ad reads.
What's that?
Max Duggan or Chandler Morris, who do you think should be the starter here?
Well, if I'm running the air raid, I'm starting Chandler Morris because I don't see how Max Duggan is, I think, a way more exciting quarterback.
Yeah.
And I think he could put defenses like you would have a hard time game planning for Max Duggan if you used him correctly.
He can still throw the ball.
He doesn't fit in at TCU.
But he's not like a...
He should have never went to TCU.
Rocket launcher of a quarterback. Well, when they like Trayvon Boykin or whatever, Boykin, yeah, like that was kind of what they were doing. It worked, but... I did see
he should go to Kansas State.
Kansas State?
Max Duggan to Kansas State.
Oh, my gosh. It'd be perfect. I don't know how much eligibility he'll have after this year, but he should take advantage of that. You're right.
Or Iowa. Go to your Hawkeyes. He's from Iowa. Go to the Hawkeyes.
Go to the Hawkeyes. Put Spencer Petras' ass on the
Colorado
bench. Yeah. A lot of places that he can work at. Now, I will say that Chandler Morris probably endeared himself pretty well to the Horned Frog faithful by beating Baylor last year in a 30-28 game. He went 29-41 for 461 yards and 2 touchdowns. That pretty much kept Baylor out of the playoff last year. Cause if they had only lost that one game and gotten revenge in the Big 12 championship game against Oklahoma State, then they assuredly would have been in there. So they returned the favor on 2014 on old Baylor.
Nice.
I don't like that.
Yeah. I mean, look, you lit him up. Anytime you light up a Dave Aranda defense, I think you're doing something right. All right, folks, I got to get us paid first. Okay. I want to tell you the College Football Experience TCU Horned Frogs season preview is brought to you by WinBet. Bet $100 at WinBet and get $100 free bet. Head over to sportsgamblingpodcast.com/WinBet. That's sportsgamblingpodcast.com/WYNNBET to claim your free bet today. We're also brought to you by Odds Trader. Odds Trader is a place to compare odds from all the major sports books. You can also compare the different signup codes from promotion, from sports book to sports book. It's really fantastic. So it will assure you the best deal. The app also provides player statistics, key game stats, injury reports, projected roster, projected game day weather for bettors who make the most informed bets possible. It also has a bet tracker so bettors can keep records of all the games. I know that's always an issue. If I'm placing like 10 bets over 4 sports, you're running around. That's great to have that bet tracker. So go to oddstrader.com/bluewire. OddsTrader, the number one site for all your game day bets. We're also brought to you by Run Your Pool. Yes, Run Your Pool is the home of competition, bringing sports fans and their social circles together to compete, to connect, and to make every game matter more. we've teamed up with Run Your Pool to, and we're hosting our own pool for our official SGPN NFL Survivor contest, free to enter. So what are you doing, folks? Get in. We got some amazing prizes that will be announced soon. So hop in now to reserve your spot. Get in over sportsgamblingpodcast.com/survivor. That's sportsgamblingpodcast.com/survivor. We're also brought to you by Sleeper. Sleeper's the fastest growing fantasy platform today with millions of players. I mean, you probably already have a fantasy league on there. I know I do. They just passed 4 million users. And with NFL season right around the corner, Sleeper's the first sports contest game built into the fantasy football experience. I mean, this thing is fantastic. All right. They have a brand new over under game where you can choose two or more players you like and pick the over under on that, on their stat projection, essentially. And if you pick correctly, you can win anywhere from 2 times to 20 times the amount of money you put in. That's pretty awesome. All right. What's that?
That bling bling, baby.
Yeah. Bling bling. Yeah. Right. And so right now on your mobile phone, join our listener group at sleeper.com/SGP and Sleeper will automatically match your first deposit up to $100. Once again, that's sleeper.com/SGP and you'll get $100 match on your first deposit. We're also brought to you by IP Vanish. Yes. Did you know that browsing online using incognito mode doesn't actually protect your privacy? That's right. Without added security, you might as well be giving away all your private data to hackers, advertisers, your ISP, and other prying eyes. That's why here at SGPN Studios, we use IP Vanish VPN. It makes it truly easy to stay private and secure on the internet. IP Vanish helps you safely browse the internet by encrypting 100% of your data. So go to ipvanish.com/SGP and use that promo code SGP and claim 70% of your savings. That's ipvanish.com/SGP. All right, we are back talking Horned Frog football. Let's talk transfer portal. Because they actually, two-way street. You know, the transfer portal is a two-way street. Well, we got to talk it in 2022 with the way the transfer portal is just batshit crazy. Patty C., here's who they brought in. Cornerback Josh Newton from ULM and Terry Bowden. Offensive lineman Ezra Dotson Oyatade from Arizona State with Herm Edwards. Defensive tackle Caleb Fox from Stephen F. Austin. Shout out to Larry Centers. Defensive lineman Tymon Mitchell from the Georgia Bulldogs.
Nice. Any defensive lineman on the Bulldogs is a plus.
Yeah, exactly. Running back Corey Wren from Florida State. Offensive tackle Robbie Rochester from UConn. Defensive lineman Law Ugok from UConn. Going with those Huskies, national champions in 2020, said the New York Times.
Got to bring that winning pedigree in.
Running back Imani Bailey from the Louisiana Raging Cajuns. And this one was big here. Offensive lineman Alan Ali, who started 39 games at SMU for Sonny Dykes.
Yeah.
That's what I mean by having four or five back on the O-line.
That's loyalty to the old coach.
Yeah. And I actually love this get too. Safety Mark Perry from Colorado. He started at Colorado. He's projected to start at TCU and they start the season at Colorado. So tight end Jared Wiley coming in from the Texas Longhorns. Safety Ismail Burdine from the Missouri Tigers. Linebacker Johnny Hodges from Navy. Linebacker Terrence Cooks from Texas. I mean, Texas guys going to TCU. What the hell's going on? The hell's going on in the world, Patty C?
Disgusting.
SMU guys going to TCU. What the hell's going
TCU
on?
I thought guys they had an going iron to skillet. Texas. Freaking Gary Patterson.
I'm saying
the TCU guy.
It's all mixed.
Texas.
All mixed up.
How do you?
All this shit is crazy.
In Fort Worth, feel about that?
So, do you think they won the portal? Because let me tell you what they lost, Patty C. We touched base on what they won, or what they brought in, not what they won.
Yeah.
They lost linebacker Javion Gibson to the portal. They lost Kari Coleman, maybe their best defensive player a season ago, defensive end, to Ole Miss. Wide receiver Michael Barkley to the portal. Defensive end Ochen Mathis to the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Offensive tackle Tyler Guyton to the Oklahoma Sooners. Brutal, by the way. Absolutely fucking brutal.
Yeah.
Defensive lineman Chris Murray to Sam Houston State. Safety Davion Armstead to Sam Houston
Oklahoma
State.
Oklahoma ain't, you know, cherry picking your scrubs.
Yeah, yeah. Running back Amonte Watkins to New Mexico State. Defensive lineman Patrick Jenkins to Tulane. And by the way, I said Sonny Cumbie was the interim coach. I'm sorry, it was Jerry Kill. but I believe they had a Texas Tech OC. You do the research on who was their OC last year.
Yeah, let me see here.
Cornerback Donovan Collins, portal. Safety Michael Onyemabe, portal. I can't talk. Defensive lineman Earl Barquette, Southern Cal. Running back Zach Evans, Ole Miss. Cornerback Tony Wallace, UTSA. Matthew Downing, a quarterback to La Tech. Wide receiver TJ Steele to the portal, and then Mark Jackson, a defensive end to Western New Mexico.
It's like last year the OC was Doug Meacham.
Okay, I'm off. I think I was thinking. I don't know why I was thinking Sonny Cumbie. I think Sonny Cumbie used to be the OC there. Sonny Cumbie was actually the interim coach at Texas Tech. So I stand corrected. My apologies.
Too much
fans.
Texas.
Yeah. but Patty C, did they win or lose the portal?
Well, you know, without having a super in-depth knowledge of each of the players' performances, I'm going to have to rely on the portal rankings.
The recruital rankings?
The recruital rankings. Recruitments. 13th nationally. Number 3 within the conference. That's a big fat W, it sounds like. I mean, obviously, losing guys to... Where were some of the places that some of their best players went?
A couple to Ole Miss, one to Oklahoma, one to Nebraska, USC. What else? I think UTSA could be a decent game.
It sounds like they've had one of the more volatile portal experiences.
Yeah, it's been wild, I think, in Fort Worth there.
Well, we're seeing that with the SMU NIL deal kicking up. I'm sure the good folks in Fort Worth have plenty of money to throw around too. You know, maybe the portal is the name of the game in a big city like that.
Yeah. What about recruiting rankings? This team recruits well, right?
Here's what I mean when I say there's a gigantic gulf between Texas, Oklahoma, and the rest of the Big 12 from a recruiting standpoint. Whether or not that's complete horseshit, you know, like Colby would often argue, and it often makes a good point. Not sure, but nationally, starting in 2018, 25, 32, 23, 44, 28. During that time frame within the conference, though, 3, 3, 6, 8. What's really curious is that it looks like the Big 12 has actually gotten better, because in 2019, they were number 32 in the country recruiting, but number 3 in the conference. So that says that Big 12 is a mediocre conference back then recruiting. This year, 2022, 28th nationally, but 8th in the conference recruiting. So that says it's a stacked ass conference in terms of the amount of talent coming in. So maybe the Big 12 is ready to survive despite the future departures of Texas and Oklahoma.
There you go. Hook 'em Horned Frogs.
Hook 'em Horned Frogs.
There we go.
Composite rankings for each of the last 4 cycles that they have recorded, 3rd each time. So they should be winning more than they have recently. I'm not sure what caused Patterson to fall off from a win standpoint. It might be the music. Maybe his heart is no longer in the game. If his players are quitting on him at TCU,
when you're going home and trying to bang out hits, all right, it's hard, man. All right,
that's right.
I'm no musician, but I've had roommates that were musicians, and I get it.
Oh, it's a labor. Like, she couldn't handle my blitz. Didn't come overnight. He didn't write that in 5 minutes.
Loves nothing but a 3-3-5 defense.
That's right. He was doing that instead of planning that 3-3-5 defense.
that relationship might not have worked so well. Patty C, if you look here, we got the win total here in the background. If you're watching on YouTube, by the way, subscribe to the College Football Experience, as we are on YouTube or wherever you listen to the podcast at. And also remember, subscribe to the College Basketball Experience. Jamie Dixon, TCU. Great year last year, and I think it's going to be even better this year. Jamie Dixon doing the damn thing. We got you covered on both, but we're just check out the YouTube page. You'll dig it. So the win total, Patty C, sitting there at 6.5. Were you a bit so? I was a little bit surprised that it was at 6.5. You?
Let me take a look at the schedule. I mean, off the top, last 4 years, what have they done? They've done 7-6, 5-7, 6-4, 5-7. So 6.5 sounds kind of reasonable, assuming if you're going to take a step forward. I mean, Dykes last year, number 13 offense overall in the nation. TCU was number 36, and that was a strong point of their team. What were they? You said like number
119
overall on defense.
Yeah.
So they can't get much worse on defense. And if they get a little better on offense because of Dykes
or Duggan or, yeah, I don't know who you want to say.
Then, yeah, 6.5 wins does seem. And then based on what they had been doing before, I expect more of this program. And then you throw in that the fact that they're pretty damn talented, it should be very doable.
Well, the juice is leaning to a 6-6 season. It's the over's at -140, the under at +120. Let's hop into it. Patty C, week one, Friday, September 2nd on ESPN. TCU heads to Folsom. Folsom Field to take on the Colorado Buffaloes.
And the last team from Texas that took a trip to Colorado.
They didn't even play in Boulder either. A&M. Yeah. They played in Denver like the cowards that they are. Patty C, I think this is a winnable game for Colorado. I think it's kind of a 50-50 game.
The fact that it's so early in Dykes' tenure is a bit scary. I do think it'll be a close game. I got TCU. Colorado was bad last year for the most part, aside from that game.
No, but I was listening to our episode the other night, Nick talking about how bad Colorado's defense was. I think that's unfair. They were on the field 99% of the game.
Touche.
They were actually, I thought, they kind of passed the eye test to me.
Do you think Colorado's offense is going
to
step forward enough?
Well, it can't get worse.
True. Very true. I know. I expect that to be a really, really hard fought game.
I'll say this. They get Tarleton State after Colorado, and then they get a bye, and then they're at SMU and Rhett Lashley. I will say that they're going to be 2-1 by Saturday, after the SMU game.
Tarleton was 6-5 last year. And what, like, are they FCS yet?
No, or they're going to beat Tarleton. I'm saying they're either going to lose to Colorado or SMU. I do not have them 3-0.
At SMU. They have a new coach too, you know,
but he was there. He was with the program just a year ago.
Who's their new coach?
Rhett Lashley.
Oh, he was their OC before. Or?
He's 1 year at Miami, but prior to that, he was at SMU. And they've beaten TCU 2 games in a row.
And it's in Dallas. I don't know. I'm tempted to lean 3-0, but maybe I'll go with you. I'll say 2-1.
2-1, and then they're home to the Oklahoma Sooners and Dylan Gabriel and Jeff Lebby. I got Oklahoma winning that one.
That's a loss.
So I got them 2-2 through the first 4 games. Then they head to David Booth Stadium to take on the Kansas Jayhawks, Patty C. If you listen to our Kansas preview, this is one of my upset specials. Jayhawks take down TCU on Saturday, October 8th.
Not me. I'm going TCU. I get what you're getting at. Leipold's team is going to be competitive in Lawrence.
Well, I mean, last year, I think this was a 3-point game, right?
Was it?
In Fort Worth?
Let me
31-28. They beat Kansas in Fort Worth.
Wow.
Now they got to go to Lawrence.
You got a point. You got a point, but I think TCU might have quit at that point in the season. I don't know. I got TCU 3-2.
I got them 2-3, and then they're home to Oklahoma State, home to Kansas State. I'll even say they're going to go 1-1 in this stretch.
That's being generous. So, but I'm tempted. You said hosting Oklahoma State and Kansas State.
Yeah. Back to back weeks.
They go 0-2 in that stretch. So okay, we both have them at 3-.
No. So I have them then at, 3-4, right? 3-4. Correct.
Yeah.
3-4, then they head to Morgantown. Light your couches on fire. I got West Virginia winning that one. I got them going to 3-5.
I think I agree with you.
Then they are home to Joey McGuire in Texas Tech, Patty C. Kind of a 50-50 game.
I'll give that one to TCU.
Sure. I'll even join you on that.
4-5.
4-5, then they head to Gary Patterson and the Texas Longhorns. There's no way I'm not taking Texas here. Oh. Texas beats TCU.
Why is that?
Because Gary Patterson, I think, is super pissed on the way things shook out.
Well, Gary Patterson shouldn't have had the 119th defense in the country.
I think he deserves a little bit of a blemish occasionally.
Did he get canned? Is that how it went down?
That's what I hear. Yeah.
Well, they did lose against Texas last year by 5. I'm not so sure about this. The more I look at Texas, the more questions I have, the less confident I am in buying into.
Is that because their starting receiver picked up an arrest yesterday?
That doesn't help. I'll give that one to Texas, I guess, but it's not a guarantee at all. In fact, I'll give TCU one of these last three games. And if it was going to be one, it would either be Texas or Iowa State.
I think they lose all three. At Texas, at Baylor, and home to Iowa State. I got this team going 4-8, maybe 5-7.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think 6.5's generous when you look at the schedule.
This might be a lock for me. They're not winning 7 games. Give me the 7 wins.
Well, 3-0, Colorado, Tarleton State, SMU, even though two of those are on the road.
And they haven't beaten SMU in
a couple years.
Yeah.
Okay, Kansas. That's 4 right there. Yeah.
Texas Tech, 5. And what are the two other wins?
Maybe Kansas State at home. Maybe West Virginia on the road. Maybe Iowa State. I don't know. I think it's a long shot.
I like the under. I think it might be on our locks episode.
I agree. I think it may be lock worthy. Sorry,
folks,
TCU.
Yeah, folks, subscribe to the College Football Experience. And we're rooting for you, Horned Frogs. Remember, check out the College Basketball Experience as well with Jamie Dixon and he's not on the show, but I'm saying we talk TCU all the time. Also, check out the College Baseball Experience. TCU's got a decent baseball program too. So me and Noah Bina host that as well. Also, check out the Sports Gambling Podcast, breaking down all 32 NFL teams with a solo episode for each and every team this preseason. So check out all that. Just had Pat McAfee on the show. Just had Mike Leach on the show. Check out all the Phil Steele. Check out all those episodes. All right, folks. Give us a follow on Twitter at TCE on SGPN. Patty C is on Twitter at Patty C831. NC Nick's on Twitter at NC_NICK. I'm on Twitter at DColbyD. Give us a follow. And folks, check out the Discord channel if you want to sweat out some bets with us. It is always fun. Doesn't matter the sport. It could be a fucking game of darts going on in fucking Glasgow.
Where is that? Scotland?
Folks.
We got you covered. You know, real quick, Colm. Looking at last year's schedule, I don't think we dove into deep enough how bad they actually sucked last year. It's a big turnaround they got in front of. Even that Cal game last year.
Oh, man. Cal blew like a 20-point lead in that.
Yeah.
They got fortunate.
It's going to be a tough road, but Sonny Dykes may be the man for the job.
Hey.
We shall see.
You know, the Leach never truly fade the Leach coaching tree. He's a friend of the program.
Amen.
All right. Folks. We're wishing TCU the best. All right. This is the College Football Experience, TCU Horned Frog style. You better start thinking about yours. And we out of here.
Sometimes it may be good, sometimes it may be shit.
I smoke and I drink and I don't have stress and I'm healthy.
At the Olympics, it doesn't matter who wins because they're all losers.
Hey, motherfucker, I eat everything, man.
My back.
What do you mean by that? You broke
back is broken.
What, a vertebrae or a portion?
Spinal.